Presentation of Badger football on Wisconsin Public Television is made possible in part by Goodman's Jewelers. For over 65 years, the diamond store of Madison. Proud of their reputation for service, quality, and value. By Madison Metro, providing Bucky bus service to Camp Randall for all Badger home games. By the Mendota Gridiron Club, the official fundraising organization for University of Wisconsin football. By Rayovac, an international manufacturer of batteries and flashlights, headquartered in Wisconsin since 1906. By the University of Wisconsin Athletic Department. By Wisconsin's best Chevy Geo dealers, 25 South Central Wisconsin Chevrolet dealers, providing sales and Mr. Goodrem's service, proud to support University of Wisconsin football. By News Radio 1310, WIBA, your Badger sports and information station. And by Funjet Vacations, arranging travel to Badger sporting events across the country and other vacation destinations.
A week ago, the Badgers' meal ticket returned to the dinner table. Ron Dayne was back in the saddle again, and number 33 didn't appear to be any worse for the wear. All the Super Junior did was chalk up another 100-yard game and spurt through the Ohio defense for three TDs. He, like his Badger teammates, had a grand time as they tamed the Bobcats in their home opener. In fact, a good time was had by all as Dory Alvarez had a chance to play most everyone that donned a cardinal and white uniform. Scott Cavanaugh came off the bench to make a pair of aerial strikes as the offense rang up 45 points. The special teams also hit on all cylinders. The spotlight fell on Nick the Pick Davis as he strutted his stuff on this punt return. And on defense, once again, Tom Burke was simply a demon as the Badgers recorded their first home opening shutout since 1971. They hope that momentum carries over into their final preseason tune-up for 1998. From a warm Camp Randall Stadium, it's the WAC to the MAC, back to the WAC again as the Badgers resume their series with the Rebels of UNLV. I'm Van Stout, joined by Pat Stigman. This is the final preseason tune-up. Live bullets, yes, but the real bullets count a week from today when Northwestern comes to town. But you want to go into that game, obviously, 3-0.
And you've got a dangerous opponent or not in UNLV, depending on your perspective. You know, Jeff Horton, the coach at UNLV, had a phrase that he taught to his team beginning of the season. He said, learn to finish. That was their goal for this year. Unfortunately for the Rebels, they've never got started. This is a team that comes in 0-2, having surrendered nearly 100 points, nearly 1,000 yards in two games, and ranks 100 or worse in the country in seven key statistical areas. Rushing and pass offense, total rushing offense and defense, total offense and defense, points scored and points allowed, and turnover margin. This is a team that comes in ripe for the picking. The Badgers are 38-point favorites. But if you're Barry Alvarez, Van, you have to be concerned. You have the number two defense in the country. You're coming off a shutout of Ohio. But if you look past these guys, two words, Boise State. We saw what happened a year ago when the Badgers almost lost to a team they were heavily favored to play against, so they can't take anything for granted.
What a real indoctrination for one Chris Hayward. He makes his first ever collegiate start, a redshirt freshman out of California, and he's going to be playing in front of 76,000 strong today.
You know, Chris Hayward came into the season as the quarterback of the future for UNLV. He's the quarterback of the present. John Denton transferred out of the program, and Kevin Crook, the starter, got yanked after six turnovers in two games. Hayward makes his debut, and it's going to be tough because he's going against the number two defense in the country right now. Statistically, the Badgers have been misers on defense.
Now, speaking of misers on defense, they've been very prolific on offense, especially one, number 33. He's 33 in the program, but number one in the hearts of all Badger fans wherever they are.
33 is a magic number for Wisconsin football, and 33 happens to be a magic number for Ron Dayne today as well, because that's how many yards separate Ronnie Dayne from Billy Merrick as the all-time leading rusher in college or Wisconsin football history. Dayne could do that in the first quarter. He could do that in the first carry. He's had a remarkable career, and we'll have a chance today to put some perspective on that as he breaks a 23-year-old record. I think it'll happen early, and I think Billy Merrick will be on hand, and I think he'll be appreciative, as we all are, as just what a tremendous athlete and a physical specimen that Ronnie Dayne is.
So the Rebels and the Badgers get set to tee it up in the final preseason tilt for the Wisconsin Badgers in 1998. Some 76,000 strong expected to be here on band day, and we have a contingent from Las Vegas that has made the trip out to the capital city here in Wisconsin. and we're going to be bringing out the telecast. They're going to be bringing it back to the entire state of Nevada and Las Vegas, most notably, on public television out there on station KLVX. Tom Weezer, a former Badger football player, I might add, was very instrumental in making that possible, and he's got about 100 Rebel fans that have made the trip here to the great Midwest, and they're going to get a sampling of Badger football right here from Camp Randall Stadium. The weather conditions, I call it Chamber of Commerce. It might be a little on the warm side, but the guys from Las Vegas are used to that. 80 degrees, clear skies, southerly winds about 6 miles per hour. Humidity will be a factor, about 70%, and last week we were told it was about 95 degrees down on the field, and there you see Jeff Horton, who's down on the field for the Rebels, and he's gone through some rocky times thus far the last couple of years. It's been a revolving door for all the assistants that he's brought in and out of his program.
Jeff Horton, of course, last man appearance here at Wisconsin a couple of seasons ago when he brought Nevada Reno in to play the Badgers in a non-conference game. He went to UNLV and had a stunning start. In 94, he led the Rebels to a 7-5 record, a share of the Big West Conference Championship, and a Las Vegas Bowl victory. Since then, it's been downhill. His team is just 6-30 in that stretch, going 2-9, followed by 1-11, 3-8, and 0-2 this season. There's some question about the future of Jeff Horton after this year. He's not worried about the future. He's worried about the present. Right now, he's got the number 14 team in the country in front of him, having come off back-to-back losses in which the Rebels have given up nearly 100 points and nearly 1,000 yards. It's going to be a long afternoon for Jeff Horton and the Rebels.
There you see number 22 for the Badgers, back deep for them, Nick Davis. And there you see what he's done on kickoff return. He's certainly been a major spark. He's also joined back there by Dante King as we await the kickoff from Lucky, number 13 for the Rebels.
The Badgers looking to start the season 3-0 in non-conference.
From about the 4-yard line, Davis goes upfield across the 20, driven up to about the 22-yard line, where Wisconsin will set up their offense under the direction of senior quarterback Mike Samuel.
And of course, right behind Mike in the lineup will be the man of the hour, number 33, Ron Dane. Sat out the opener against San Diego State with the ankle injury, came back at 111 yards, 3 touchdowns, and a brief three-quarter effort a week ago in the 45-0 shutout of Ohio. And today, he has history in front of him as he tries to catch Billy Merrick as the all-time career rushing leader at University of Wisconsin football history.
Ron Dane, and Dane picks up about 7 yards. The numbers on Ron Dane coming in. He had 111 yards last Saturday in his first effort of 1998 on 20 carries. That to go with 3 touchdowns. Averaging just over 5.5 yards per carry. Here's a look at the Wisconsin lineup up front. Or check it, pick it in the backfield. Samuel Dane, Martin, Merritt Chambers, and Retzloff, the tight end. And up front, from tackle to tackle, some pretty big old guys. McIntosh, Ferrario, Robach, Costa, and Gibson. Set the Rebels defense. The next opportunity, 2nd and 4. Play fake. They look to pitch outside to Cecil Martin, trying to turn it upfield. And the Reb defense did a nice job to double-team him. In to make the stop was Anthony Brown, the free safety. 7 solo tackles coming in. Brown out of Las Vegas, a backup in 97. Guess what? He's a starter this year. Redshirt 1994. His uncle was the starting free safety at Kansas. And here's a look at the Rebs defense. Jones, Kirkpatrick, Darnell, Sawyer, Ferrucci, Sania, and Gale. And in the secondary, the Badgers are faced with a 3rd and 2. Field Batoon in there for the first time. Brown and Thomas. Dane to the outside, across the 40, across the 50 into Vegas territory. 1st and 10, Ron Dane. And there you get a glimpse of the guy that's some 250 pounds and the speed that he has to be of that mass.
It's amazing with Ron Dane. You know, he's still battling the ankle a little bit. He said even last week he wasn't 100% ready. He saw on film as he watched the game against Ohio some moves that he thought he could have broken it if he was Ron Dane at 100%. Even on this play, Ronnie Dane gets out in the secondary, gets some space, gets dragged down from behind, but he inches ever closer to Billy Merrick's record. Dane off the field on this play.
Carlos Daniels replacing Dane. Eddie Faulkner not expected to play, still bothered by the shoulder injury. 1st and 10 for the Badgers in Vegas territory, and there was some movement of the defensive front. Daniels jitterbugs for about 3 yards, but I think that play will be called back as there was some contact between the defensive and offensive lines of UNLV and Wisconsin. I think the call will go against UNLV. There you see David Witvoet, who is the referee today. Offside is the call. He's joined by Percy Munn, Dennis Gattell, Tony Michelak, Carl Britt, Bob Bassett, and Jack Lyman. There you see Wisconsin's head coach, Barry Alvarez, with one more win. He will join Milt Bruin as the winningest Badger coach in the modern era. I have not been around for as long as the modern era. I've been around for a long time, but not that long. I think they consider the modern era starting at about 1950 to current day. There you see the all-time rushing leaders before we started.
Right.
Is added to that. He remains over on the sideline. Daniels gets the call, waits for the hole to open up, gets a push from the outside. Might have been McIntosh who's pushing Daniels for an additional yard or two. Sets up a second, and we'll call it maybe a long two.
Ron Dane with 32 yards thus far today, tying him with Mr. Merrick as the all-time career single-season rushing leader, or career rushing leader overall, that is, and needs one more, and his next carry will break the mark. But he is not in the ballgame. Carlos Daniels, 39, remains at tailback.
Billy Merrick has made his way into our booth, and we'll talk to him as soon as he dons the headset. Samuel, and that ball was batted down and intercepted, and it's going to be a touchdown. The Rebels have only one interception coming in, make it two, and it's the second interception of the year by a lineman. And just like that, has the complexion of this game ever changed? We've seen this script before.
Been there, done that. Boise State a year ago.
Ted Darnell goes the distance.
You mentioned, Van, the only other interception UNLV has this year is by a defensive lineman. Make it two now. The ball is batted up in the air. Samuel cannot play defensive back on this play. Darnell picks it and has easy running all the way to the end zone. And UNLV, just like that, up on the Badgers with the first touchdown of the game.
Wow. That certainly silenced this crowd. O'Reilly in to attempt a point after, and it's good. And he is now 3 of 3. The Rebels lead 7-0.
Harking back to a year ago, very first offensive play is scrimmage against Boise State. Wisconsin lost the football on a pitch. Boise State picked it up, took it back, and for the touchdown, had a quick 7-0 lead, and because of it, the complexion of the game changed immediately. It gave some immediate confidence to a Boise State team that went on and battled hard. If it weren't for Mike Samuels' touchdown run late in the fourth quarter in that game, the Badgers would have been upset. As we sit here today, the Rebels have done the same thing. It's what Jeff Horton was looking for out of the gates today. He needed something to instill some confidence in the team that really lost its confidence when John Denton, the starting quarterback, transferred out of the program in the offseason, has been struggling to find some reason to live in a football sense ever since then. They have it right here today with the great play by Darnell and the surprising 7-0 lead.
You see Mr. Davis back trying to perhaps make a nice return to get Wisconsin back into this. 12-32. Lots of time left, but certainly it puts a damper on Wisconsin's initial drive as they were trying to set the tempo, much like they did last Saturday when they put some quick points on the board against the Bobcats of Ohio.
That's Mike Samuel's second interception of the season. Both times were tip passes. In this case, clearly, a hand got up in the air on the defensive line. Darnell was there to scoop it up, and just like that, it's 7-0.
I don't know that I could see who actually deflected that, but you got to credit the defensive front by the Rebels. That's what they're taught to do. Davis from the 6-yard line, across the 20, straight up the field. Look out. Look out. He gets to the outside, across the 50, to the 40, tries to cut it back down to the 31-yard line. Nick Davis pumps up the crowd.
What's the best way to deal with a big play against you? Come back with a big play for you. That's exactly what Nick Davis came up with for the Badgers. Rather than let Wisconsin sit back and take the sting of the interception and the touchdown for UNLV, Nick Davis makes things happen right off the bat on the ensuing kickoff. We talked about this young man already frequently in this early 1998 season. His ability to run north-south, his vision, his ability to get outside, and more importantly, his ability to turn on the jets once he gets out in the free territory. And Wisconsin, thanks to Nick Davis's return, starts inside UNLV territory at the 32.
Number 33 is back in the backfield. And he gets the ball. And I think that's going to eclipse the mark of one Billy Merrick, who joins us now. We'll get a shot of Mr. Merrick as Ron Dana has broken the mark, the all-time rushing mark. And listen to the crowd as they are in appreciation of number 33.
It wasn't the prettiest run in Ron Dane's career, but history made a handoff from Merrick to Dane, and Ron did what he's done so many times in that situation. He took the ball and ran with it. Great appreciation for Ron Dane, number 33, the new career rushing leader in Wisconsin, and great appreciation for Billy Merrick, who joins us in the booth. And Billy, it's a delight to see your record fall.
But Ron certainly is a tremendous back, and I wish him well throughout the rest of his career.
Option to the outside. Nice pitch by Mike Samuel, who gets up, and he's going to go to the sideline for a half. Gets up very slow, very gingerly. I dare say that, Billy, that you had a few one-yard carries for as many times as you lugged the bacon.
That kind of epitomizes college football. It's a lot of parity. It's a tough game, and it's hard enough just to stay healthy.
Can you imagine a guy the size of a Ron Dane that's as quick as he is?
Well, he's got great agility besides his speed, and I'll tell you, trying to stop him at full speed is an incredible feat itself.
Dane is over on the Badger sideline, having been replaced by Daniels. First man through, Cecil Martin spins, chunks it down to about the 12-yard line. Cecil Martin, a rare carry for the Badger fullback.
Billy, your record lasted for 23 years. At the time, did you have any thoughts, any ideas that it would be the longest-standing significant record in Wisconsin football history?
No, I had no idea. I mean, it was, there's been so many great backs throughout all of the years that we just had a great run, and I was lucky enough to last that long, and it's surprising that it lasts that long with all the great backs.
Tailback a lot of times is only as good as his blocking fullback, and you had a couple of good ones between Ken Starks and Lawrence Cannon.
Kenny was very quick, and Larry made some big holes.
Speaking of big holes, there goes Carlos Daniels right up the gut, down to about the 4-yard line. Not a bad second guy, and actually he's the third string tailback for Wisconsin with the injury to Eddie Faulkner. As we talk about that, let's take a look at number 26 in action. The days that you start for the Badgers. Nimble-footed that he was.
Now there's all the film.
And you're right, it is film, too.
It was a different era. You had offensive linemen that were smaller than Ron Dane, correct?
Yes, it was different. A lot of speed, though.
Trying to get down to the 1-yard line and trying to get in for the 6-point plunge. I believe the ball carrier was Daniels once again, and obviously with the heat, I think attrition is going to be a factor. Las Vegas traveled with only 56 players, and having talked to their sports information director, in his recent memory, he could never remember any team from Vegas traveling with only 56. You're allowed to travel with 60.
And Ron Dane, we've talked about the hoopla and obviously the great significance of the moment with the mark, but you have to question his health again. He's off the field. He's had an ankle. He's over on the sideline on the bench being attended to by the trainer.
Daniels stood up. Might have been a loss of about one on the play. It's going to set up a third and goal from about the 2.5, maybe even the 3-yard line.
Billy, setting a record like this, the key to it is consistency and the ability to be on the field. You had one carry as a true freshman and then three straight 1,200-yard seasons. How difficult is it in the Big Ten, week after week after week, to stay healthy to set a mark like that?
You take quite a pounding. Every week is a new venture. There's many times that you roll out of bed and your stomach muscles are pulled, your legs are pulled. It's tough week after week, Ron, and he's carrying extra load. He's a lot bigger guy. He's got a lot of weight on his ankles.
So it's third and goal from the 3. Samuel, wide open. He's going to try to throw it. He's going to try to run it. There's some interference in the end zone. It's going to be an automatic first down. I think interference against Las Vegas, perhaps, or maybe against Wisconsin. Have to wait for the call.
Good call from Brad Childress up in the booth. Going to the bootleg down when they're anticipating the run on the goal line situation. Mike was looking for Chris Chambers on the far side of the end zone.
Well, he's also looking at the tight end, Grant. Have to wait for the men in black and white to make the call, but Chris McIntosh, captain of the offense, along with Cecil Martin over there, and it would appear as though it might have been defensive pass interference. Here's the call.
Holding. Defense. Pass possession penalty. Repeat, third down.
So it's going to move up about a yard and a half closer. Now it's going to be third down and goal from about just shy of the two-yard line, or just shy of the one-yard line, if you will. Badgers on the short end of it thus far. Not the first time they've trailed this season. They trailed on the road at San Diego State. They never trailed against the Bobcats of Ohio. And thanks to a pass deflection and an interception return for a touchdown by Darnell, Vegas has the early lead. Again out of the eye, Daniel got the eye. Here comes the option. Samuel, hurdle, touchdown. Mike Samuel on the option, kept it himself, and gets the Badgers on the board. You have some pretty good quarterbacks too back when you played with him.
We had Greg Bowling at quarterback the entire time we were there. My sophomore and junior year. And we had Mike Carroll and some other people coming in and out my senior year.
I came to Madison in 1976. Unfortunately, I just missed your era, but there were a lot of players who were still around. Lawrence Canada among them. Can't think of his name, the tight end who had a pretty good career with the Denver Broncos.
Ron Egloff,
there you go. It's tough to get old. The point after is good by Money. Money being Matt Davenport, and the Badgers at the 8:55 mark have knotted it up at 7. Probably not exactly the way that Barry Alvarez figured that his offense would get on the board after a return for a touchdown and an interception. And you see Mike Samuel having lugged the bacon in there for his second rushing touchdown of the year.
That's the 15th rushing touchdown in Mike Samuel's career. Numbers more like a tailback than a quarterback, but he gets it done again, and the Badgers come back and tie it up. And going back to the size and speed, Billy, we were talking about that. You had Dennis Lick and a Terry Steve and a Mike Webster in the line in front of you. All those guys playing at, what, 230, 240, 250 max?
Somewhere between 230 and 245 or 50, you bet.
How is it? I mean, you look at it, and Aaron Gibson at 6'8", 390 pounds on the right tackle. For
well, there were very few defensive linemen of any size either, so it was fairly matched.
How significant is it? As the years have gone by, have you held on to this record and felt, you know, something cherished about it, or was it just inevitably it was going to fall and it felt great to be remembered as part of Wisconsin history?
Well, it's kind of nice that two or three times people got close because all of a sudden they might even pay a little attention to an old guy like me sitting here. But no, it was very nice, and we had a great career, and a lot of guys could be proud of that.
And Alec Lisetsky last week, you see the numbers last year, 5 of his 8 kickoffs were good for touchbacks against the Bobcats, and he's got the wind at his back, so with a pretty strong kick, he would be led to believe that he should be able to pin it back into the end zone once again. Angles it to the near corner, and I don't think it's going to be returned. It's not. So Vitaly Pasetsky continues and picks up where he left off last Saturday with another touchback.
Billy, we appreciate you joining us today. I know you've got a lot of folks here are happy to see you back in Madison. We'll leave you with these parting thoughts. Can you just give your assessment of Ron Day and how much further this young man can go in his career?
Well, there's no question in my mind Ron Day could be playing in the NFL right now. He's a tremendous athlete. He's got great speed. He's got great agility. If he can stay healthy, he can go a very long way. I'll hope I could be as big as fan when he's in the NFL.
We appreciate it.
Pleasure to see you. Okay?
You still have the touchdown record. That's 5 away right for Ron. Thanks,
a little
Billy.
While, right?
Enjoy the rest of your
Thank
day.
Thank you.
Last individual in one, Billy Merrick, making his first ever collegiate start for the Rebs. Chris Hayward, first time the Rebels have been on offense, and we've got about 8.5 minutes to go in the first quarter.
So nothing going according to script here so far in this ball game.
No.
Chris Hayward is the quarterback, as you mentioned, Van. James Wofford, the tailback, and that outstanding trio receivers. Williams, Baker, and Ware could be among the three best collection of receivers in the country.
Hayward coming in 7 of 10 last week in their loss. One touchdown. No interception. The Rebels expected to put the ball up in the air, but so far they've kept it on the ground in their first few plays. Wofford is the ball carrier. Wofford's numbers, 22 carries, 72 yards, has yet to score a touchdown. Just over 3.5 yards per carry up front for the Badgers. First, Eric Mollick in for the injury, the knee injury. Kalaji, Dorsey, Thompson, Adamoff, the backers, and in the secondary. Fletcher is expected to return today with an ankle joint back there. Under 8 minutes to go. Here's a little swing pass to the outside, and there you get a glimpse of the speed of Lenny Ware, coming in, the Rebels' leading receiver, 14 catches, over 13 yards per reception. Myers on the stop with one touchdown for Ware, and he's a junior out of Rancho Cucamonga, California.
But a wide receiver screen, you're going to see Chris Hayward try to get the ball in the hands of Baker, Williams, and Ware all day long. That's the dangerous trio for this team. It's the only offensive threat, really, that they've shown all season. Ware has three touchdowns in his career, better than 75 yards, seven 100-yard catching games. He's a big-time player.
Flush from the pocket. Trying to run the ball now as Hayward. Hayward gets it into Wisconsin territory. Sets up a second down and about six to go. The key in this game is the ability for Hayward to get rid of the ball on the three-step drop and the ability to Wisconsin defensive front to try to get some pressure on him and maybe get him to have some happy feet a little bit.
No question about it. The Badgers have five sacks already this season, and Hayward is purely a drop-back quarterback, as is Kevin Crook, who had started the first two games before being benched in favor of Hayward today.
The Rebels will try to run it, and not much room for Wofford.
UNLV has been banged up. In addition to their lack of execution on the offensive line, they've had a lack of help. They started the season with all-whack tackle Mike Riley out with a knee injury, and then Danny Pacheco, the starting right guard, dinged up his shoulder this week and did not make the trip. So Blake Livingood, 6'8", 330-pounder, makes his first career start at right guard, number 77.
Going downfield, and it's going to be caught, and it's fumble, and it's recovered by Wisconsin. A break for the Badgers as Taylor makes the recovery for Wisconsin. A major break there, but you know what? It's a game of giveaway, takeaway, and credit the Badgers for stripping the ball, and then Taylor for coming up with a loose pigskin.
The Badgers had their giveaway on the pick early on, and you're right. This is sort of a good news, bad news. The bad news is that UNLV is moving the ball up and down the field. In this case, Hayward with a perfect pass over the top. The Badgers unable to make the stop on defense, but the ball does pop loose. Strip free right there by Leonard Taylor, and Taylor is able to gain his feet and recover the football for Wisconsin. So if you're gonna give up the big play, make sure you make something happen on the back end. And Taylor did just that.
He
stripped the football and recovered it.
Adamoff, I think, stripped, didn't he? Adamoff on the strip. Here you see Jeff Horton. His ball club, at least his offense, is starting to gain some yards. They've had problems doing that in the first two games. Here's Dane, not much running room for number 33. Of course, with each subsequent yard, he adds to his now school record in terms of rushing yards.
50 carries and 5 attempts now for Ronnie Dane. He needed just 33 to surpass Merrick. Did that, and now next in the sights is Darnell Autry, number 11 in the all-time Big Ten Conference race. If Ryan gets 117 today, he'll surpass Autry, and that will start to climb up the top 10 list in the Big Ten annals. Ultimately, Ronnie hopes at the back end to catch Archie Griffin as the ultimate team member of the Big Ten.
The Rebels on a blitz, Samuel, and he just unloads. He got some heat, and Samuel did a pretty good job to unload it, and he was in the end zone, so kind of a risky play, because if it's grounding there, that can really burn you. I don't know if Samuel saw the blitz, because the DBs from Vegas were showing it very early on. Not sure if he had a chance to check off. Cecil Martin checked out. Nick Davis replacing him.
A.C. Smith, the outside linebacker, came on the blitz that time. And that's one thing that Jeff Horton will do today. He understands that to beat a Wisconsin team and the offensive caliber and the size of a Big Ten squad, that he's going to have to shake things up, come at him in a blitz. And you go back to the San Diego State game, they were coming at the Badgers hot and heavy all game, and it gave Mike Samuel some fits.
So it's third down and 7 for the Wisconsin offense on third down this year. Not real prolific. 10 of 25, 40% coming in out of the shotgun. Samuel goes upfield and caught by Davis. The ball goes squirting out of bounds. It'll be Wisconsin's ball. First and 10, Samuel to Davis.
You just get the sense it's going to be one of those days, Van, with the interception, that the Rebels take it back for the touchdown, then Davis answers with the long play, then Dane has the hoopla with the rushing record, and then there's the long pass that the Rebels look like they may score on, but in fact fumble the ball back to Wisconsin, and now Davis is involved, fumbles the ball out of the end zone. You have to come prepared to play and concentrate on every single snap, whether you're playing the number one team or the number 108 team in the country.
Scary stat if you're Vegas defense. Opponents have converted on almost 66%. third down opportunity. Going for the home run, and it was thrown out of bounds. Chambers was bumped out of bounds. Pretty good coverage on the play by Randy Black, the nickel back for the Rebels.
You mentioned the struggles for UNLV statistically coming in. Defensively, 108th against the rush, 100 against in total defense, and 100th in scoring. That's out of 108 teams in the country. Offensively, they're not much better. 108th rushing offense, 103rd total offense, and 101 scoring. The Rebels have had their woes so much so that the local paper dubbed them Rebels without a clue.
Badgers coming in ranked 14th against ranked teams. The Rebels are 1-8. Here's Dane staying on his feet and depending on the spot whether or not he got the first down. And that was just pure second effort by Ron Dane. He looked 100% there.
Patience, picking and choosing, waiting for things to develop and not forcing the action. Ron Dane has the ability of his size to force the action when he wants to, but this is what he's learning. He's in behind Gibby, not much room to move. He lets the block play off, slips to the left side, and cuts up in the middle for a first down for Wisconsin.
So, in fact, it is a 10-yard pickup for Dane and company. They'll change the fourth Wisconsin offense back out on the field after Adamoff stripped the Vegas offense of the ball on a pass completion.
And Dane back on the sidelines. You saw there testing that ankle. And you wonder, I said this in the opener, you wonder if it's going to be a season-long thing. Nothing against Ron Dane, but those ankle injuries tend to nag and lag throughout the season.
Daniels across the 40 to about the 41-yard line, a pickup of about 3. Carlos Daniels, a redshirt freshman out of Pennsylvania.
For all the hype we've talked about Ron Dane, and legitimately so today, who's the leading rusher on the Badgers coming into the game? Not Ron Dane.
No.
It's Carlos Daniels. Who's got the highest single-game rushing total this season for the Badgers?
Well, it'll be
Carlos Daniels. He had 113 in the opener against San Diego State. Dane with 111 a week ago. So Carlos earning his keep, and as you mentioned, with Eddie Faulkner sidelined at least until the Big Ten opener, those two are going to be the tailback cannon for Wisconsin.
Vegas shows blitz. They pick it up to the sideline. Chambers, good patience that time by Samuel, allowing Chambers to make the cut, and he threw the ball on a zip, and it's first and 10 for Wisconsin as they move into Rebel territory.
You got to like that matchup for Wisconsin. Chris Chambers, rangy. Hey. Budding star from Wisconsin going against Andre Hilliard, number 26, who's just 5'8", 155 pounds on the right side for UNLV. So Badgers don't have the size of a Hayes and Simmons, but Chambers can definitely work against the smaller D-backs.
Chambers has about 38-inch vertical leap, too. Samuel, home run ball. Chambers in and out of his hand. Pretty good coverage that time by Hilliard. JUCO out of El Camino, and the ball was there. Chambers was there. He just couldn't hang on.
Let's be honest, man. Obviously, Wisconsin comes into the game as a huge favorite, 38-point favorite. Hey, the score is tied right now. But one of the things the Badgers want to get accomplished today, in addition to obviously winning the football game, is to get the throwing game in place, because the Big Ten openers are a week away, and they know they can ride a Ron Dane. They know they can even ride a Carlos Daniels if they have to. But can they move the football in the air up and down the field? So far today, Brad Childress is throwing the ball by 40% of the downs.
Second and 10. Daniels straight up the gut. Look out. Daniels on his feet to the 30-yard line. Ron who?
Maybe you think Daniels is on pace to beat Ron's all-time career rushing record? Carlos has really matured in a short amount of time.
Dane didn't start until the fifth game of his freshman year, so Carlos Daniels, a redshirt freshman, has certainly had an impact in the wake of the injuries to both Dane and Faulkner. Chad Coons checks out, and a very special story there for the Badgers last Saturday. They gave him a game ball in view of the fact that his dad had just passed away, and he elected to stay with his Badger family and scored a touchdown last Saturday as well. Martin inside the 30, maybe down to about the 29-yard line. Not a lot of running room for the big fullback as Dane will check back in, and he's going to replace Daniel.
You mentioned Chad. It was a very emotional week, obviously, for he and his family. And our condolences obviously go out to the Chad Coons family. But one thing it showed, you talked to a man on the team, Chad, and his teammates, and even the coaches alike, it talked about emotional bonding of this team. Unlike some Wisconsin teams in the past, and that's not a knock on them, it seems that this team genuinely has a great affection for one another. The players hang out together on and off the field. They do so in the offseason, and that's the type of bonding that you need as you move into the season.
Mike Samuel was not happy with the way that they were setting up, at least against the defense that he saw out on the field by the Rebels. So he opted to take a timeout with 2:52 in the opening quarter. Wisconsin following the fumble by UNLV, trying to take the first lead. The Rebels got on the board as a result of a deflected pass returned by Darnell for a touchdown, some 60-plus yards. And there you see Mike Samuel talking to Brian White, his brother Chris, handles the special teams for the UNLV Rebels.
Interesting story, the two White brothers, they look exactly like each other. I mean, with their glasses on, particularly on the field, you couldn't pick the two apart if they weren't wearing different colors. Chris White was a four-year starting quarterback at Colby College in Maine. Of course, Brian White was the starting quarterback at Harvard, and the two of them are now coaching different positions. Of course, Brian was on the UNLV staff and came to Wisconsin to take over as the running backs coach. And you see Chris White there, his brother, who's the special team coordinator and middle linebacker coach of all things, a former quarterback. But both of those young men have great coaching careers ahead of them. And I know Barry Alvarez is happy to have Brian White on his staff. He's made such a great impact in both the running game and in the passing game, working with Brad Childress and Mike Samuel. And of course, Chris White is hoping that he can help fortunes turned around out of UNLV.
The other games, this is the final weekend of the non-conference schedule for most of the teams. Indiana on the road. And you see the rest of them. Second down and 9 to go following the timeout for the Badger offense.
We've had information from Wisconsin.
Chambers in motion. On time. Samuel pulls up. Goes downfield. Wide open. Chambers inside the 5. Touchdown. What a great play call from Brad Childress and company, and that play was wide open, excellent execution.
Wisconsin continues to work that left side of the secondary for UNLV. They've looked there in just about every passing situation so far. This time, great play action. They keep two tight ends in the block. Mike Samuel looks downfield and sees number 88, who's got separation against James Keel, the senior cornerback, and it's nothing but 6 for Wisconsin and Chris Chambers.
Second touchdown reception of the year for Chris Chambers. Second of the year for Mike Samuels. Guess what? They both took it. I figured that out. Matt Davenport going after, and it's good. And the Badgers have doubled their pleasure against the Rebels by a count of 14-7 with 2:46 to go. So Wisconsin has 7 points, the direct result of a turnover, as do the Rebels. 7 points as a direct result of a takeaway.
Chris Chambers, of course, had a huge spring game for Wisconsin. 7 catches, 143 yards, showing his stuff and showing his potential, and he's unleashed it. The 60-yard touchdown against San Diego State being one, and look at this. Great separation. Nice toss from Mike Samuel. All you got to do is get the ball in his vicinity at that point, and Chris Chambers does the rest.
I think that's being called faked out of your, you know what, because they bid on the play fake. They bid on the fact that they thought that Samuel was going to perhaps run the option down the line, and then he pulled back, and as he pulled back, the defenders had already moved up, anticipating the option, perhaps by Samuel, and there you see Chris Chambers getting some liquid refreshment as he and the Badgers have taken a 14-7 advantage.
UNLV had lost 41-7 to Northwestern in the opener on the road, and then last weekend at against Air Force out in Vegas, lost 52-10, and this is an Air Force team that UNLV took down to the wire a year ago, and you could tell that they lost the confidence from 97-98.
Pasecki, and it's going to be another touchback, so Pasecki is 2 of 2 in kickoffs. So the Vegas offense will come back out onto the field, and they're going to be forced to play catch-up, something they've done thus far in their two earlier games, as Pat said.
Wisconsin defense coming off perhaps its finest statistical performance in the Barry Alvarez era, the 45-0 blanking a week ago of Ohio. The Badgers allowed just 102 yards on the ground. That's the lowest total ever in the Alvarez era. And Ohio was just 3 of 7 passing for 37 yards. Those also the lowest figures in Barry's stay in Madison. The Badgers second to only Kansas State statistically nationally coming in today with the best defense allowing just 153 yards a game.
Pretty good running room that time, though, by Wofford. Wisconsin held consecutive opponents to less than 100 yards rushing for the first time since 1986, the Jim Hillis era, the 1 year that it was.
Three victory season led to the Morton era, such that it was, and ultimately, thankfully, the Alvarez era. You know, UNLV came in with just 29 total yards rushing this year, but a lot of that has to do with sack yardage. Of course, in college football, the sack yardage counts against the rushing total, sacked seven times.
Almost sacked. Now, Edward is going to run for the first down. He takes the hit by Adamoff and drives Adamoff out of bounds. So, Hayward showing his ability to run with it. A classic drop-back quarterback, 6'4", 210-pound redshirt freshman out of San Clemente, California. Spotted at the 38-yard line. 2 minutes remaining in the first quarter.
Sorry, Van. Barry Alvarez being true to his word. True freshman Joey Bose on the field as a corner, not just a special team star as he has been in recent weeks. With these four wide-out sets and the one back, or in this case, no backs, you have to have many D-backs in the field.
Shotgun, here comes the pressure. There goes the flag. Hayward driven down, and he's going to be trapped and sacked for a loss.
John Favre.
I think the penalty might go against the Rebels, and if that's the case, I believe Wisconsin might decline illegal motion. They'll take the play, and here comes big number 77 into the lineup for the Wisconsin defense, Wendell Bryant, 6'4", 290-pound true freshman out of St. Louis, Missouri. He's already got a sack this year and just celebrated his 18th birthday last Saturday.
Hard to believe. He's a big man and a young man.
Illegal motion. Offense. Penalty is declined. Second down.
And now he's the man of the moment because with Ross Kalaji injured, he strained that knee against Ohio. The Badgers are going to continue to rotate and shuffle inside. Malik and Brandon Williams will be the featured players replacing Kalaji, but you'll see the likes of Wendell Bryan and George Pratt even on the field today.
Favre now with three tackles for loss and his second sack, and there again is some dirty laundry on this magnificent new turf at Camp Randall Stadium.
Talk about injuries up front for the Badgers. Not only Kalaji.
Prior to the snap, ball starts. Offense, 5-yard penalty. Down remains second.
So now it's second and 15 for Jeff Horton's offense.
Kalaji out of the ball game with the injury. We see the motion penalty. No question about it. The living good making his first start. A little anxious to get off. But the Badgers also without a couple of backup defensive ends. Donnie Eicher broke his arm in practice this week, and Sam Miller has swelling in his knee, so they're thin indeed.
Hayward goes up the field, and is it caught? Yes. Waiting for the referee to say yes, and caught by the tight end, Sam Mineo.
Preseason All-WAC selection.
He was second team All-WAC in 1997. Had 15 catches and 3 touchdowns a year ago. Hayward with good presence under pressure.
You know, Hayward came into the game a week ago after Crook had thrown a second interception and finished 7 of 10 for 133-yard passing and led the team on an 80-yard scoring drive. Again, they didn't expect to play in this early in his career, but so far today, he's acquitted himself well.
Third and four. Here comes the blitz, and that ball is deflected. A nose for the ball was Bob Adamoff, who arrived at the same time the ball did. Pass intended for Damon Williams, and good coverage by Adamoff. So the Badgers turn away the Rebs on third and four.
Williams has already, with two catches today, extended his streak of consecutive games with at least one catch to 37, but Adamoff denied him on that play, and now we're going to see Nick Davis, or actually Timmy Rozga, back to return the punt for Wisconsin.
Rozga, the lone deep man from Wisconsin. That ball is deflected by Burke, and it goes out of bounds. Tom Burke. The punter is Joe Krstasik, and Krstasik, I think he took his own good time, and Burke, showing great speed, got in there and got a piece of it.
I don't know that I've ever seen better special teams play in my tenure around Wisconsin than we've seen already early on in this 1998 season. Jay Hayes, the special teams coach, Barry Alvarez, pumped up on the sideline on that play. Rozga had a block punt out at San Diego State. Burke now gets a piece of this one. and puts Wisconsin in great field position inside the plus 50 territory, inside UNLV territory.
You know, now we're seeing some of the reasons why UNLV has obviously struggled to 0-2 record. It seems like when they created a mistake, it's been a bad one. Samuel, Daniel trying to get to the outside, trying to turn it up the field, and the Rebel defense did a pretty good job to string out that play. Talant Sawyer.
Sawyer's
making the stop.
Sawyer's the big playmaker on that defensive unit for UNLV, such as it is. He's the first player ever in UNLV history to receive first-team all-defensive WAC honors and led the league, the WAC, last year with 18 tackles for loss.
He had 7 sacks as well. He's an ex-tight end. Got the size. And the first quarter has come to an end, and what a wild one it's been. Ron Dayne has become the all-time leading rusher in Badger history, and Wisconsin is out in front of the Rebels by a score of 14-7.
For anyone who's fallen in love,
she's my everything now.
For anyone who's fallen on hard times,
been tired of being shot down every time.
For everyone who's held on to a dream.
Whatever it takes to make things work between us all, I'm willing to do anything.
The Farmer's Wife, the Frontline Special.
Monday through Wednesday at 8, only on Wisconsin Public Television. Presentation of Badger football on Wisconsin Public Television is made possible in part by Goodman's Jewelers. For over 65 years, the diamond store of Madison. Proud of their reputation for service, quality, and value. By Madison Metro, providing Bucky bus service to Camp Randall for all Badger home games. By the Mendota Gridiron Club, the official fundraising organization for University of Wisconsin football. By Rayovac, an international manufacturer of batteries and flashlights, headquartered in Wisconsin since 1906. By the University of Wisconsin Athletic Department. By Wisconsin's best Chevy Geo dealers. 25 South Central Wisconsin Chevrolet dealers, providing sales and Mr. Goodwrench service, proud to support University of Wisconsin football. By News Radio 1310, WIBA, your Badger sports and information station. And by Funjet Vacations, arranging travel to Badger sporting events across the country and other vacation destinations.
Second quarter is underway. Second and 8. Straight up the gut. Look out. There goes 33 inside the 20. We were just talking about the bad ankle, huh? I don't think he was, he had a little hitch in his skinny up there. Probably slow in getting up last week on his second touchdown. Ron Dayne, apparently his breakfast did not agree with him. And he left the deposit on this new turf here at Camp Randall Stadium.
Thank God it's Stainmaster.
Yeah. Dayne comes out, not showing any signs of a,
you know,
a hitch in his giddy up. But
part of it is that, you know, you want to protect the ankle, but you also need Ron Dayne to get some hits and play, because you can't have a Ron Dayne not ready for football action going into the Big Ten season.
First man through, Martin down to about the 6-yard line. Cecil Martin, the first man through. And that's about the third carry for Cecil Martin. That's an entire season been last year.
Cecil just goes about his business every play. You know, he sat on the sidelines last week and watched his two backups, Chad Coons and Marcus Carpenter, both scored touchdowns in the second half. Cecil's went, where's mine? But you see that, 245 yards on the ground. That's a game for Ron Dayne sometimes. But Cecil, one of the great guys on this football team, one of the quad captains for the Badgers in 98.
Second and 1 for the Wisconsin offense. Daniels, look out. Daniels down to the 1-yard line. He dished out some punishment there. Mike Samuel was knocked to the turf on the play. He gets up okay. So it's first and goal for the Wisconsin offense. They came in, depending on which service you consulted, about a 37-point pick. I say the bottom line is, you know, when you look over the scoreboard, it says Bucky nothing, Rebels nothing. There are no favorites when it comes to the scoreboard. The favorite is what you make of it. Daniels remains in at tailback. He's joined back there by Chad Coons. Samuel calls his phone number, and I believe he's cut down. Yes, sir. Mike Samuel, he's thrown one. He scored one.
Mike Samuel does what he does so well around the goal line, finishes the deal. He does it one of two ways. He either sticks it in the belly at 33 or, in this case, takes it himself. Touchdown number two for Mike Samuel, rushing today, the 16th of his career. Five now behind Dale Hackbart for the all-time Badger single quarterback touchdown record. 21 for Hackbart in his career. Now Mike Samuel has 16, his fourth already of this season.
Roska on the hole, waiting to snap his neck. Money splits the upright, and Davenport increases the Badger advantage to 21-7 is Mike Samuel. I might correctly say now has a second rushing touchdown, and we'll take one more look at it from Mike Samuel's viewpoint as he'll run right into your living room.
And right over the back to Casey Rabach and Dave Costa, 54, the right guard, part of that young trio that matured so quickly in the offensive line, Ferrario, Costa, and Rabach, and right up the middle, Mike Samuel punches it in, tough, gritty quarterback, doing what he needs to do to help Wisconsin win. Again, he's been involved in three turnovers this season, none of which really were his fault. Two interceptions, both on tip passes, and one, the fumble at San Diego State, in which Carlos Daniel, the freshman, missed the block on the linebacker who came in clean and was able to knock the ball out of Mike's hands. So Mike has done what he's expected to do so far. Admittedly, we're in the non-conference, we're not in the Big Ten season. But so far today, Mike Samuel has accomplished his goals of being a mature fifth-year quarterback, finishes the deal, finishes drives with points. The Badgers now up 21-7.
Kosecki now will be kicked into the wind for the first time. And I think at the outset, the winds were out of the south about 6 miles per hour. Well, from looking at the flags throughout the stadium here, it appears though that breeze has picked up, which is good because with some 75, 76,000 in here, it's a warm September afternoon.
Wayne James, number 16, is the return man, the key man, the threat to the rest.
Kosecki hangs it up high and deep. And James is going to take this one 2 yards deep. Trying to get to the sideline. A good return by Dwayne James coming in, averaging 27 yards per kickoff return, which was good for 20th nationally. And you got a glimpse of why he is as proficient as he is. There is a flag on the play.
Personal foul against the Badgers. See number 42, Ben Herbert, the true freshman, into the lineup at linebacker for Wisconsin. The officials sort this out.
With a dead ball, personal foul, late hit on the defense. 15-yard penalty, first down.
Now, that's not a good mental play by the Wisconsin special teams.
There have been
good return by James, but then you give him 15 more yards on a late hit.
That's a pretty questionable call. I think they're going to call it on Bryson Thompson, the true freshman, but he just finished off the play, fell on the pile. I don't know if that's a good call.
Corey Hankins in the ball carrier. He's a junior out of Phoenix, had three starts in 1997. In fact, led the team in rushing a year ago, 641 yards to go with two touchdowns.
Talking about the true freshmen, they're all over the place for the Badgers. Right now, Wendell Bryan on the field, Joey Bose. You saw Ben Herbert in the lineup, number 42. They took the redshirt off him today on the special teams because of the injury to another true freshman, Nick Bryson, who had a hamstring injury and will probably try to get a medical redshirt for the season.
Flush to the pocket, trying to scramble. Upended on the play by big number 96 for the Wisconsin defense, Bav Ray.
Good pressure by the Badger front four, but also nice coverage on the back end. I tell you what, Lenny Ware and Carlos Baker are both frustrated receivers right now for UNLV, going and complaining to the officials. They didn't like the way they were being manhandled by the likes of Taylor and Bobby Adamoff and Bobby Myers on the back end. Nice physical play by the Badgers. And Favre gets it done up front for Wisconsin.
Another of those two freshmen just came to the sideline, Jack Sprague, out of Old Creek. Third and eight out of the shotgun. Eccles corner. And Eccles almost came up with his second interception of the young fall.
Wisconsin has three picks this year, all by freshmen. Mike Eccles, Jamar Fletcher, and the true freshman Joey Bizet with the three interceptions. Eccles almost added to four.
We kind of like what you see on third down opportunities. Of course, UNLV has not been very proficient. 8 of 28, 28% coming in, but the Badger defense has looked strong.
I like what you see from number 22 as well, Nick Davis, punt returner, 113 yards return kick a week ago.
Kostasic, and good job there by Davis, making the Rebel return. He had a couple of guys about ready to pop him. trying to deke him in, a 54-yard boot by Kostasic. His longest this year is 57. He had the wind at his back. At least he got it off. He is very mechanical back there. You notice
no
that?
Question. And you see he's being talked to on the sidelines right now because that's the time where you don't want a 54-yard boot. At the 46-yard line, you're trying to pin that ball down inside the 10. That ball landed 5 yards into the end zone.
After you got the last block.
That's true.
The most important thing is
that's
get
true.
It off. Okay?
That's true. But at the same time, it's only a 34-yard net punt because Wisconsin, with the touchback, takes it back to the 20.
I'll tell you what. Mr. Davis does not play like a true freshman.
Nor does Bose, nor does Wendell Bryant, nor does Ben Herbert, nor does Jake Sprague.
I mean, this is just a good middle play. I mean, he's got me beat. All right, there it goes. And then, oh, now he goes.
And he covers up. I tell you what, the Badgers obviously go out and recruit the best talent they can find. But when you pull in a guy in a program like a Nick Davis or a Joey Bose, both of which had outstanding high school careers but didn't have the attention from some of the major colleges, for whatever reason they didn't fit the height chart or the weight chart or the speed chart, whatever the case may be, but you know what they are, Van, and this is an old tired cliche, but it's a cliche for a good reason. They're football players. They care about being on the field every minute, every day. That's what they live for out of here as college football players. They don't want to be sitting on the sideline watching their teammates get it done. They want to go out and contribute now.
Is that kind of like their future's ahead of them?
Their future is ahead of them.
All right.
This is true.
Somebody
using my words against me.
You know, they being the Rebels are going up against the Carmel and White, but it's been up.